What up, you nerds? Fallout here, and today is the first day of Season of the Splicer, which can only mean one thing. We're all waiting around for Bungie to untangle the absolute cluster that is their servers. First, we were kind of limited to hanging out in orbit, then we got shut out completely. Oh well, day one problems, am I right? While we're waiting though, figured I might as well do a little homework. Hopped on over to light.gg, a website I highly recommend if you've never heard of it before, which has a ton of new info about what's coming down the pipe in season 14. If you're looking for info on the new aspects and fragments, I'm planning on putting out that video tomorrow if I can, so be sure to ring that notification bell. Today though, I wanted to take a look at all the upcoming info regarding artifact mods and give my initial thoughts on maybe which ones to prioritize getting before going out into the field. Naturally, because we're all locked out of the game right now, at least as of the writing of today's video, many of these I don't have hands-on experience with, but several are old mods being brought back from another season. Definitely stick around until the end of the video though, because there are some cracked options in there that you're not going to want to miss, especially for the upcoming Vault of Glass raid. First up, we've got our usual anti-barrier, unstoppable, and overload options. Season 14 features anti-barrier auto rifle and anti-barrier scout rifle. I'm kind of bummed out because we already just had an anti-barrier scout rifle, but no big deal. It does its job well and allows you to clown champions from far away. Anti-barrier auto rifle sounds like it could be fun though. Season 14 has a new auto rifle called the Chroma Rush, which can potentially come with perks like Kill Clip, Rampage, Thresh, Wellspring, and even the brand new Adrenaline Junkie, an extra damage dealing perk that I'm sure I'll dive into at another time. Remember that anti-barrier is probably going to come in clutch in the Vault of Glass raid. Hobgoblins are annoying AF, and either anti-barrier scout or auto rifle with good range will be able to continually damage them even while they attempt to regenerate. Just something to keep in mind. In the overload department, we got overload SMG and overload hand cannon. Overload SMG, to me, feels like one of the least reliable ways to stun an overload champion in the game. You never stun with your first shot, and it leads to goofy situations where you're desperately trying to hose down some jabroni champion who's teleporting all over you. IMHO, overload hand cannon is going to be the far better pick. Bungie loves hand cannons, and by now, players probably have a ton of sick nasty rolls, all with their favorite perks lined up and ready to go. Not to mention that hand cannons are usually more forgiving in the range department, meaning you can stop overload champions without having to be right up next to them like an SMG. For unstoppable, we have sidearm and grenade launcher. Kind of a really weird combination, TBH, and even though we have a hot new exotic sidearm that can freeze enemies in one shot, I'm thinking that grenade launcher is gonna be the play. Not only with unstoppable champions, but with a lot of other things, which we will soon talk about. Quick reminder, one of the new weapons in the game as of today is a brand new kinetic grenade launcher. It's stupid easy to get to. All you gotta do is load up the very first intro mission and complete it, which you could probably do blindfolded, and then bam, kinetic grenade launcher. Don't panic too hard, it doesn't fire in a perfectly straight line, so it ain't like the mountaintop, don't worry. In the dexterity and reload department, we have both scout rifle reloader and rocket launcher reloader. I think both are gonna be great. I really love the idea of doubling down on rocket launcher reload mods and then unleashing a hellstorm of wild rocket DPS on a raid boss. Yeah, a lot of people these days, including myself, just kind of roll with auto-loading holster rocket launchers, but whatever, there's potential there. Scout rifle reload is meh on the surface, but also could be great. Dead Man's Tail is still a damn powerful gun. On mouse and keyboard. And it can really only benefit from the extra reload speed. Mida Multi-Tool also got a big buff, so I'm sure the extra reload speed for cheap won't hurt there either. Grenade Launcher Dexterity is on the artifact for one energy, and I guarantee you I'll be using that perk with a build I'll touch on later. It's worth mentioning that Nade Launcher Dexterity is the only dexterity mod on the artifact in Season 14. Not really sure why Bungie went that way, but whatever. We've also got Unflinching Auto Rifle Aim and Unflinching Pulse Rifle Aim. I think I'm more hype about the Unflinching Pulse Aim in PvP than I am for Auto Rifle, mainly because I think Auto Rifles aren't really hot in PvP right now, and it would probably take either a drastic sandbox change or a really good new gun to make it any different. Closing out of the low end of artifact mods, we have Grenade Launcher Scavenger and Rocket Launcher Scavenger. I think PvP players are about to get really annoyed at other people going into PvP with double Nade Launcher Scav for a grand whopping total of 2 energy. PvE players, though, are probably jumping for goddamn joy. Grenade and Rocket Launchers are still really good damage dealers in PvE, so if you've got a top tier launcher, there's really no reason to not slap that mod onto your Guardian. Now, I'm gonna jump around the list a little bit, because I can't log back into D2 at the moment. I don't really know where the following armor mods are on the artifact, but it doesn't really matter. Impulse Recycler, Grenade Final Blows grant grenade energy. Multiple copies of this mod do increase the amount of energy gained. That is interesting. PvP Warlocks might actually be tempted to play handheld Supernova for the first time in what seems like forever. I'll have to do a little digging when we're allowed back in the game to find out just exactly how much energy we get per each stack of this mod. Something else you should be aware of, in Season 14 we're getting an all new wave of Elemental Well armor mods. I feel like Impulse Recycler might be pretty good in helping to make Elemental Well mods actually competitive with Warmind Cell mods. Keep your eye on that, could be important. Next we have Energy Accelerant. Any explosion from Dragonfly, Chain Reaction, and Firefly is going to deal more damage. Seems like to me it's going to be a really solid pick for PvE only, unless the boosted power of the Boom Boom is really through the roof. Mostly though, I'm going to keep Energy Accelerant front of mind for any PvE activity that involves a lot of repetitive ad clearing. Glacial Inheritance is back to potentially cause more trouble in PvP. If you're unfamiliar, defeating targets with your Stasis Super will refund you more super energy. The amount of refunded energy given isn't a ton, but honestly, any amount of energy given back on a super is kind of a pain in the dick for PvP. The only upside about Glacial Inheritance is that it costs 6 energy to apply to your armor, so it ain't cheap. Next we have Sundering Blast. Stunning a champion creates an explosive blast. Seems fairly straightforward to me. Stun a champion and boom. I wonder what kind of blast it'll be though. If you stun a champion with an arc weapon, will it make an arc blast? How big will the blast be? How much damage will it do? Even though it doesn't mention it at all on the mod, will it be able to pair together with Energy Accelerant? I kinda doubt it, but hey, you never know. Bungie told us that holding on to Iron Banner bounties wouldn't give us new loot when held onto from season to season, and my brand new sniper rifle begs to differ. Anyway, yeah, Sundering Blast seems like it'll be good for Lost Sector farming. Whip it out if you can. Moving on. Surge Detector. Shouldn't be any surprise here, we've had this bad boy before. Arc grenades disrupt combatants, stunning them, delaying ability regen, and lowering combatant damage output. Strong against overload champions. Definitely a good perk, could potentially pair together with Impulse Recycler if, while throwing said arc grenade, you could get a couple trash level ad kills as you stun the champion. Unstoppable Schwarzschild Condenser is also back. Void melee abilities stun unshielded combatants. Strong against unstoppable champions. Not a bad pick for any hunter mains out there. Throw a smoke bomb on a charging unstoppable champion, and boom, you're good. Basically, you get more loadout options. Rather than feeling forced to use either a sidearm or a grenade launcher for unstoppable, you can use your melee ability to stop a champion. Although again, if you're not a smoke bomb hunter, don't know how eager I'm gonna be to run up and pimp slap a charging champion. Next, we got Hammer of the Warmind. The detonations of Warmind cells you destroy cause disruption, stunning combatants, delaying ability regen, and lowering combatant damage output. That's huge, a Warmind cell mod on your artifact free for anybody to use without any trouble. As you probably know, Warmind cells are still godly good in PvE and don't really show any signs of slowing down. I'm gonna bet you $1,000 that whatever team wins World's First on day one Vault of Glass will probably be using some variation of a Warmind cell build. Now I know a lot of people out there like to dick ride these solar Warmind mods pretty hard, the ones that deal immediate death to every enemy in a short radius. But there are times in a raid where there are enemies you shouldn't be shooting, at least not right away, like the Aatrax encounter in Deepstone Crypt. I think Hammer of the Warmind is definitely going to be viable, and you should try to incorporate it into your PvE build and fiddle around with it to see if you like it before VOG. Next up, shockingly, another Warmind cell mod, Warmind's Decree. Void splash damage final blows have a chance to create Warmind cells. That's pretty huge. Up until now, players have been relying on dealing solar splash damage to make Warmind cells outside of using Aikalos weapons. This is really going to expand the pool as to what you can use to make a Warmind cell with. I've got a God Roll Truth Teller grenade launcher with auto loading, and even though it's not an Aikalos weapon, you can bet your ass I'll be using it with Warmind's Decree to make more Warmind cells. Quick reminder that if you feel like you're totally out of the loop with Warmind cells and very late to the party, not to worry, I got a video on the channel you can check out that breaks everything down very easily, link in the top right corner now. We're getting to the end here. Ashes to Assets, nothing new there, but a great armor mod for both PvP and PvE. Gain bonus super energy on a grenade kill, straightforward and damn helpful. Paired together with Impulse Recycler and maybe even the new Elemental Well armor mods, you might be looking at a hot combo. Reminder that Ashes to Assets does stack, but with diminishing returns. Blast Radius and Argent Ordnance are both on the Season 14 artifact. Argent Ordnance will give you improved damage and reload speed when whipping out a rocket launcher while charged with light. Damaging any enemy with a rocket launcher will consume one stack of charged with light. If you're wondering, hey, why use that over high energy fire? Well, maybe you want to save your beefed up damage on a big bad boss, and there's some hive knight following you around trying to carve some bacon off your back. With Argent Ordnance, it'll save your charged with light damage for when you whip out a rocket launcher, not on your next weapon kill with any weapon. Again, if you're confused about charged with light, don't be. I got a video guide covering all that ish in detail. Check the top right corner now or the link down low in the video description. Blast Radius allows you to become charged with light by rapidly defeating multiple enemies with grenade or rocket launchers. Huge, will only cost you one energy, and again, considering how good grenade launchers are going to be in Season 14, you're going to want to tinker around with Blast Radius. Okay, finally, the one I've been saving for the very end, Breach and Clear. When using a grenade launcher, damaging a boss, damaging a champion, or breaking a combatant's shield reloads your stowed weapons and causes the combatant to take increased damage for a short duration. God damn, I don't know if that's gonna sink in right away with a few people, just how stupidly good that armor perk is. All you have to do to activate it is simply damage a boss, a champion, or break a shield, and now all your stowed weapons are reloaded and you get a damage buff on that target. No surprise to me at all. The cost for this armor mod is 9, I repeat, 9 energy. That is a wildly expensive mod, and I can see why. There's no reason to think that Breach and Clear wouldn't work with exotic grenade launchers like the Anarchy and the Wither Horde. Anarchy alone is already a primo damage dealer in PvE, and by simply causing any damage to your target, you're now making them more vulnerable to all incoming fire. My Truth Teller grenade launcher, I can tag some boss, then switch over to whatever damage dealing weapon I want. Sleeper Simulant, a Lasting Impression rocket launcher, a sword, doesn't matter. Yeah, a lot of Breach and Clear's potential is going to be heavily determined by two unknown factors. One, how long the window of increased damage will go for, and two, how much more damage will the target take? Although at this point, I don't really think it even matters. Even if it were something pitiful, like a 5% damage buff would be huge for raid teams trying to clap Atheon's cheeks in record time. Tons of teams going into the newly revamped VOG on day one are gonna be using Breach and Clear, bet on it. Now that we've covered every armor mod perk, look at how many of them pair well together with grenade launchers. Breach and Clear, Grenade Launcher Scavenger, Warmind's Decree, Blast Radius, Unstoppable Grenade Launcher, and Grenade Launcher Dexterity. You got more ammo for your launcher. If it's void, you can make a Warmind cell with it. You can get charged with light for cheaper on multi-kills. You can swap out your grenade launcher quicker. And of course, the insanity that is Breach and Clear. At this point, I think D2 servers are finally back online, so I'm gonna wrap up today's video and hop back on to get my hands a little deeper into the dough. Be sure to swing by my Twitch channel this week. I'll probably be tinkering around with builds and all the new stuff Season 14 has to offer. If you enjoyed today's video, click the like button, really helps me out, and don't forget to subscribe and help me with my oh so humble goal of one day becoming the sole ruler of the world. Thank you very much for watching, and I'll see you next time.